Hello and welcome to this project pack tutorial covering template 2301 of the Old World Swallowtail Butterfly. I've broken the tutorial into parts, with this video being part one. It's filmed in real time, excluding the drying time between layers, so feel free to speed up if you like, and the same goes for slowing down. To start off, we're just going to make sure that you have everything you need. Obviously the template 2301. I have three brushes, a size 2, 4 and an 8. And have my set of paints, a paper towel, and my jars of water. I'm going to presume that you've already stretched your watercolor paper and it's already taped down. And if not, I suggest you pause here. Click the link in the description below to watch my video on how to stretch your watercolor paper first. For our first layer, we're going to lay in a flat wash of a creamy yellow color. Remember, we always mix our colors ahead of starting to paint all the different sections. I've made my color using a combination of yellow ochre, a dark brown, and I've added water to get a light color. Before I start laying any of this onto my painting, I make sure that I'm happy with the color on the swatch card. Using my size 8 brush, I'm now going to start laying in this color onto the main area of the butterfly, focusing mainly on the wings, both those on top and underneath. Although the body of the butterfly is back, there are lighter hues that pull through, as you can see in the reference, so we paint this in as well. And so that the bottom wings of the butterfly are more distinguishable from those of the top, we go in with another layer just to give them a slightly darker hue. Thank you. With the foundation layer painted in, I'm going to leave this to dry completely before we go in with any other colors. Hit pause here until yours is fully dry before you carry on painting. I'm now going to mix my next layer of colors, and I'm just going to reuse some of that yellow ochre cream mix that we made. I'm adding a bit of a dark brown to it, and I'll add a bit of black as well until I achieve the hue that I'm wanting. I'm aiming for a rich black color, and why we don't use black straight out of the pan is because of that reason. It's not rich enough. So you'll see that I'll also be adding a bit of purple, a little bit of blue, and even red, just to add a bit of richness to that black. Using my size 4 brush, I'm now going to start painting in the head and the torso of the butterfly. On the outside edge of the head, I am going to be using a little bit of water straight on my brush just to sort of blur that black out to the edge of the sides of the head. Once I've laid in the body, I'm gonna wash off my brush, dry it, and then just lift on each of the segments of the body as we go down. And while the body's a little bit wet, I am starting to go in with a yellow ochre outline around the body, hoping that it'll bleed in a little bit of that color so that it's not as stark a separation. Thank you. I'm going in with a bit more black paint, just adding some depth to the torso of the butterfly. With the foundation layer dry, I'm now just going in with some of the details, like the strong yellow ochre line on the left hand wing. I'm also going in and adding the antenna detail. This is how we should be looking so far. I've left the body to dry, and now I'm going to be going in with a bit more of the detail around the head. I've mixed a bit of the red sienna color and some yellow ochre to make that fuzzy bit at the front of the butterfly. and I'm painting in that lighter yellow ochre line on the right hand wing of the butterfly. I'm now going to be working on the details on the left hand bottom wing, starting with the section alongside the torso. Using the tip of my brush, I'm going to be creating tiny little hair-like structures along the torso, so short brush strokes and keeping them nice and tiny and light. Do the same on the right hand side, keeping my brush strokes short and tiny. I'm now working in the detail of the bottom wing, and you'll see that I use short brush strokes filling in the spaces between the creamy gaps, just so that it looks like how a butterfly would, with that sort of fine hair texture. I'm not too worried initially about the black being slightly transparent, as you might cross over lines. It's just to lay this in, and we will always come back in the third layer to darken up the sections that need darkening. As you will notice in the photo reference for this butterfly, this section of the wing is actually sort of black with yellow spots, but we can't achieve that when you're working with watercolor. You're more rather going to paint in the black, and I'm doing so in a sort of speckled motion, creating yellow spots by the gaps I leave behind between the black dots. Now that we've laid in the black, we're going to add our pops of orange colour in the butterfly wings. And while I wait for sections to dry before I lay in my blue, I'm just working in some detail with the yellow ochre into the sections of the wing where we might see more shadow, as you can see in the reference. With the black now dry, I'm adding in my blue. Thank you. I'm going to leave this here for part one of the tutorial. Please will you click onto part two to complete the butterfly.